92.3 K-Rock. Howard Stern and Robin Quivers, Earth Dog Fred Norris, all back on the air again.
Howard.
All back together. We almost went to Los Angeles.
Howard. What's happening?
Turn down your radio, babe.
All right, no problem.
I don't mean babe derogatorily. You know that.
Hey, listen, man. From New York, I got New York roof from Ace. And Kiss. You're back in New York, right?
What did he say?
I don't know.
Sam,
you know, it occurs to me. It occurs to me we forgot to bring our,
New York roof from Kiss. You're back.
We forgot to bring our, drum in today.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, I'm not even, like, in... I'll tell you what's been happening. We've been doing club dates. We were up at the Kendallwood Playhouse in New Fairfield, Connecticut for four shows this weekend. And we brought all our stuff to the club dates, and I forgot to bring it here to K-Rock. And speaking of club dates...
We've got more coming up.
We got a lot of big announcements to make. I have two big announcements to make. I'm wondering if I should make one of them now. Maybe after the news, I have a very big announcement to make.
Okay.
I mean, a major Howard Stern announcement.
Wow, okay.
Yes.
Howard.
Yeah.
I'm afraid you're going to kiss me.
All right. You're on the air.
Hi.
Hi.
Can I talk to Howard?
Yeah.
I hear that you're back on the air.
Yeah, thanks. It's pretty good for us, too. We missed you.
I have been listening to you every day, well, when you were on the other station, but we won't talk about that.
Yeah, hey, are you going to help bury them?
Definitely.
All right.
Yeah. Damn, sucks.
AM definitely sucks, and that's what I always said. We always belonged on FM.
I know, you always did.
I know, it was like...
Being there was
I'm
like...
I'm so glad that you're back on.
Thank you. What was that, Robin?
Are you going to do, Dialogue Date and,
Can these people hear me?
No, I don't think... I think you're going to have to start working in here or something, because I don't think anybody can hear you.
They assured me that they would be,
Why not?
I would be heard.
Can you hear Robin now?
No. Not
yeah,
at all.
I thought.
Just got a phone thing.
Yeah, we got to get the kinks worked out of this place, man. It ain't gonna work if they can't hear Robin.
Excuse me.
It's what's happening is every time you're talking, Robin's talking.
Yeah, you don't hear me.
I saw you on the Happening Show on Bog Show. I couldn't believe you did that show.
What do you mean?
Well, you always knocked him and everything, you know?
Oh, you want to hear about that? That's weird. I did the Bill Bog Show. Like, when you get fired, man, the first thing that goes through your mind is get publicity.
Uh-huh.
And, like, you know, the front page of the Post and all that stuff. And I said, you know, what I should do is do a bunch of different TV appearances.
Right.
So Bill Boggs' show, Comedy Tonight, I didn't know, you know, what it was or anything, so I decided to go on. I wasn't even sure what time it was on.
Right.
So I go on, and, we created like a, you know, a big, we did that show a big favor.
Yeah, we created media hype.
The afternoon show, the midday show.
Oh, the midday, well, just wait a second, let me talk about that.
Okay.
So now, I didn't think like it turns out David Letterman goes against Bill Boggs at 12:30 at night.
Right.
And I think the Letterman people are uptight about Boggs. I don't know why, because the Letterman show is clearly better than Bill Boggs' show, but...
Now what are you doing?
Well, even Bill admits it. Now I'm not going to be on anyone's show.
Joe Franklin.
Yeah, I hope Joe Franklin doesn't get offended by anything I say. I still need an outlet. But let me just finish the story.
Okay.
So, but you got to realize, like, I was in a state of shock. I just lost a job that I didn't think it was possible that I'd ever lose.
I know.
So, I'm sitting there thinking, well, how do I continue the media hype? So I go on Bill Boggs' late night show.
Right.
Then Letterman's people call me up and say, do you want to be on the Letterman show? And I said, sure. Mm-hmm. And then they read in the Post that I was on the Bill Boggs show, and they cancel me off of there.
You're kidding.
But you see, I figured I'd never be allowed on the David Letterman show again because...
You were fired from NBC.
Yeah, and I figured, like, NBC wouldn't allow me back on their TV stations. But it turns out that NBC is pretty hip about that kind of stuff. They don't, I got to hand it to them. They weren't that vindictive.
Uh-huh.
I don't know.
And I don't see why they should be vindictive in the first place when they fired me.
Yep.
Because NBC's attitude is like, they're copping an attitude now that, like, I quit or something. But they fired me.
Yeah.
We listened to you that last day that you were on that Friday.
Yeah.
And we couldn't believe it, what was happening. And we felt so bad. And we're saying, gee, I hope you're back on, you know, in New York.
Yeah.
Because you really cheer us up for the ride home. It's great. Sometimes... You are so funny, we had to pull over, actually, because we were laughing so hard.
Yeah, and how come Marvin Kittman says I'm not a good comedian?
You know, politics, right?
Yeah, but anyway, so now Letterman's people gave me the word that I was canceled from their show.
Forever?
I don't know. They said that they'd have me on again, but they haven't called, so I think it leads me to believe that Letterman has kind of, like, held it against me that I did the Bill Boggs show. And hey, man, I don't really think that's fair.
He hasn't called you?
No.
Oh.
I don't know. What can I say?
And it just shows you where show business is at. I felt like me and Letterman were kind of having a relationship.
Yeah.
Like a friendly relationship. No, seriously, I really did. And it just shows you, everybody's our show business, man. So, okay, I screwed up and I did the Bill Boggs show one time.
Well, what I'm not on you for that.
Yeah, oh yeah, he is. And the thing is, they're going to hold it against me now forever and never let me back on the Letterman show.
I'll go let you on. You are so popular. Everybody's talking about you.
All right. Thank you. Now everyone's talking about you also.
You're going to be popular too.
See, there's a lot of people driving in the car saying, boy, all the same idiots are calling in. Well, thanks for your call.
Hey, have a good day.
All right, and now make your station 92.3 K-Rock.
Definitely.
Isn't this a happening station or what? Are we happening?
No, we're really happening.
Meg Griffin, Tony Pig, Jay Thomas. Mike Coppola.
Hey, maybe we can get in a movie now.
Yeah, Mike Coppola. He's Francis Ford Coppola's
nephew or something?
No, he's Francis Ford Copulates. It's the wrong one.
I'm sorry about that.
Oh, there he is.
You're gonna have Donna Fiducia on?
Well, I don't think so. I mean, we'd love to, but you know, unfortunately, I don't think they do traffic reports here. All right, Beth, thanks for calling.
Okay, have a good day.
I think you've had one too many questions.
All right.
Nice talking to you. 92 K-Rock, don't you love it? This is a regular honeymoon going on the air, Robin. 348 W, oh, will that ever get out of my mind?
Sure.
All right. 348 at the new 92.3 K-Rock, and let's talk about the Yankee Stadium Motel. I've spent many a night
Yankee
there.
Yankee Stadium Motel?
What a hype.
It's real hot after a baseball game.
New York's originally loved motel, yes. Special short stay rates. Oh, man.
What?
71 luxurious guest rooms. 5 special rooms.
What do they have in the special rooms?
Well, they have a penthouse in the sky, New York skyline motif, enclosing large double bed with 5-foot by 7-foot bathtub, whirlpool,
ooh,
jacuzzi. 2, 3, 4 or more could dive into it from the bed.
Wow.
Greek tub.
No!
With steam in bath.
What was that?
Greek tub. Space Odyssey Suite, same features under the stars, the Hermit's Hideaway, beautiful cave-like, stucco enclosed bed with steam bath.
Stucco always turns me on.
Disco Fantasy, striking graphics make these two rooms extra special and sexy. Free in-room triple X movies.
Ooh, triple X?
Yes. No hidden charges, all credit cards accepted. For information and reservation, call 588-1111. It says mention phone numbers at least twice. Yes, this is a phone number we should mention 3 times. 588-1111. 588-1111. Conveniently located on the northbound service road of the Major Deegan Expressway at West 167th Street in the Bronx.
The November stop on the K-Rock World Tour is you and a friend in Paris for Dire Straits. We'll select our winner this Wednesday and announce the next leg of the K-Rock World Tour. We can't reveal it right now, but for those of you who'd like to keep a packed suitcase handy, here's a little hint.
Hi, this is Roger Daltrey. You're listening to 92.3 K-Rock, New York's new choice for rock.
We've asked owners of every make of car to be with us today. All
21 at the new 92.3 K-Rock. Robin, what do you want to do? You want to do news? Or maybe we should do a song. It's up to you. I'll let you call this one.
Yes, did you say something to me?
You want to do news or you want to play a song?
We can do whatever you want.
But we're going to take a phone call.
Why don't we take a phone call, then do news, and then get back into music?
Mm-hmm.
Can we do that?
That sounds good. Hi, the new 92.3 K-Rock.
Hi, Michael Powell.
Yeah, it's me.
Oh, hey, I can't believe I got through you. I saw you Saturday night.
Oh, you saw us?
Yep.
What'd you think of the show?
I like it better on radio.
Whoa.
Well, that's not a negative comment.
Well, you're good. I guess it takes time to see you, different perspective.
Yeah, what show did you go to?
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock Saturday night?
Yeah.
Oh, that was a good show.
Yeah. Very good.
Yeah. We're not doing live performing. We're doing Club Binet Thursday night, but it's all sold out. It's not like we need your business.
Well, listen, $50 once a week is enough for me.
Yeah. It was $25 a seat. What are they charging at Binet?
I think it's $22 with dinner or $17-something without.
Oh, with dinner. Excellent. Hey, we should mention that we're going to be holding a contest at Club Binet.
Yes.
Yeah, what kind?
For the Thursday night show. We just don't do a stand-up act. We have video, we have music. It's like a whole, you could tell people, it's like a multimedia experience. I've been over my house. I've had him out to my house on Long Island. I've broken bread with a man. My old general manager never once visited my house. Never once.
I called him. His secretary was very nasty.
Oh, really? What happened?
Well, I said, well, are you fired? And she said, well, don't you listen to Howard Stern? I said, yes, that's why I'm calling.
Oh, like don't you listen to Howard Stern? Like, all of a sudden...
But that explains why you were fired.
Yeah, that doesn't explain... Don't you listen... You know, for 3 years...
That's the attitude.
For 3 years, people used to call up and say how horrible we were, and they would say, well, then just change your radio dial. Then all of a sudden I get fired. They say, well, don't you listen to that? Mm-hmm. How could we let that on the air? Interesting, you know? Interesting.
How wrong we were for 3 years.
Yeah. Yeah, so were we. Anyway, it's 356 at the new 92.3 K-Rock. I tell you what, we're going to play some ZZ Top for you. Isn't the music better here?
It's great, but I'm missing you. I'd rather have you than the music.
Shh. I know.
I know.
Right now they're into the... It's good. It's good. It's a good mix. Us with the music. Just relax.
Okay. Great to have you back.
Yeah, great to be back. The new 92.3 K-Rock. Oh, yes. Listen to this. This one is, Robin, this is ZZ Top.
All right.
This is new from them. New music. 356. At K-Rock. We'll be back with the K-Rock News. Robin Quivers. More of your phone calls. And a very big announcement. I mean a real big announcement.
How big?
Major Howard Stern announcement.